that he had brought his sorrows to an unpromising market. "Tom, I've a notion to skin you alive."
"Auntie, what have I done?"
"Well, you've done enough. Here I go over to Serenity Harper like an old softy, expecting I'm going to make her believe all that rubbage about that dream, when lo and behold you, she'd found out from Joe that you was over here and heard all the talk we had that night. Tom, I don't know what is to become of a boy that will act like that. It makes me feel so bad to think that you could let me go to Serenity Harper and make such a fool of myself and never say a word." This was a new aspect of the thing. His smartness of the morning had seemed to Tom a good joke before, and very ingenious. It merely looked mean and shabby now. He hung his head and could not think of anything to say for a moment. Then he said,
"Auntie, I wished I hadn't done it, but I didn't think."
"Oh, child, you never think. You never think of anything but your own selfishness. You could think to come all the way over here from Jackson's Island in the night to laugh at our troubles, and you could think to fool me with a lie about a dream, but you couldn't ever think to pity us and save us from sorrow. Auntie, I know now it was mean, but I didn't mean it to be mean. I didn't, honest. And besides, I didn't come over here to laugh at you that night."
"What did you come for, then?"
"It was to tell you not to be uneasy about us, because we hadn't got drowned."
"Tom, Tom, I would be the thankfulest soul in this world if I could believe you ever had as good a thought as that. But you know you never did, and I know it, Tom."
"Indeed, indeed, I did, Addie. I wish I may never stir if I didn't."
"Oh, Tom, don't lie. Don't do it. It only makes things 100 times worse."
"It ain't a lie, Addie. It's the truth. I wanted to keep you from grieving. That was all that made me come."
"I'd give the whole world to believe that. It would cover up a power of sins, Tom. I'd most be glad you'd run off and acted so bad. But it ain't reasonable, because why didn't you tell me, child?"